to show time freedom too.
Yep.
And if our team sees us working 60 hours a week, what type of freedom is that? That's not freedom. So you also, you have to have boundaries and you have to have time set because, you know, you do, we have the freedom, you know, to work when we want, you know, and be with our kids and things like that. But if you're working 60 hours a week, that's not much freedom. So definitely, I love that. How can a shy introvert gain influence? I will tell you guys that I am not, I don't think I'm an extrovert. The study thing, or what is that, thing's called? I wouldn't say I'm an extrovert. Yeah. I was an ENFP, I think.
You're an extrovert.
I don't think I'm an extrovert. Okay, I'm an extrovert in the fact that I love to be around people. I love people. I don't like it when people are staring at me while I'm talking. I do not like talking.
You're an ambivert.
That means an extrovert is someone who gets their energy from being around people.
Okay. Well, I have that part. I just don't like it. I don't like talking in front of people. Let me get to my point. Because I think to gain influence, you have to step out of your comfort zone. You have to do things that make you uncomfortable. I tell my team all the time, I'm like, I know you don't want to do that live video. Do it scared. Because the more you do it, the more you'll want to do it, and the more influence you will gain. I did a makeup tutorial on a live. I'm like, I'm just going to go do it. I'm going to get in my bathroom. I'm just going to put my makeup on in front of people. For one thing, I was without makeup in front of Facebook, which was a huge step for me. The second thing is I was doing something that I love to do, and I was showing people that. And people were like, oh, well, that's cool. I had, like, my daughter's hilarious. She was like, Mommy, you got, like, 4,500 views. You're famous. You're, like, viral. I'm like, that's kind of cool. So, but then I did a messy bun tutorial for Melissa because she didn't know how to do a messy bun.
I still know.
But
I still think about it all the time. I'm like, I think Laura said I'm supposed to tease right here.
Really messy. Just gotta get. It's a mess. But like, do things that you're passionate about, and put it out there for people. Everyone has a gift.
Yeah.
You know, and so get out of your comfort zone. That is how you're gonna gain influence. I don't know whose question that was, but it was great because I think that was that's really good. What do you do when nothing is happening in your business? And Aaron trained us on that activity. You gotta be in activity every single day. And whether it's your own IPA where you're reaching out to people, and also developing your leaders, reaching out to those leaders and saying, what can I do to help you in your business? What can we do today? Doing a coaching call, whatever it is, that's activity too. You know, getting people to help them reach their goal. That's my favorite thing to do, is help other people. And my team knows that. I love to talk to them, see what they're doing, what their fears are, build a belief in them, tell them what they're doing good, and things like that. So I think, that's for sure. And I have more here. Why did I get two cards? What do you feel like has contributed most to your success? God, there's so many things. I think the number one thing is duplication. Belief and all that, to me, Melissa helped me with that. I didn't believe in myself at first. She was believing in me for myself. But duplicating. Melissa's an amazing leader, but what she had, I took and I ran with it. Because I'm like, I want my team to see me. You know, and so I think duplication is huge in our business, and it will definitely get you where you want to go, because you're the people that you bring into this business, they want to see you lead. They want to see you do things, not other people. And duplication, it goes with everything. It's like going silver, like do this, do that, you know. And so duplication was with it. To me, I think that helped me the most. What specific actions do you do to build belief in others, and build business builders? I think talking to people and hearing them and sharing my own vulnerability. Hey, I struggled with that too. But let's get through it. Let's talk through it. I think being an active listener. I think with Melanie, I mean, she's my jewel. And I think we got together a lot. Like, we met at Panera a lot. You know, and so just being with her, building that belief in her, showing her what she can do. I think getting face-to-face with people is super important. If you can't do that and you're out of town, I think Zoom is great. We have that resource. And so just getting with people and talking to people one-on-one, I think is huge. So, if y'all have anything to add to that.